Have you ever noticed how big of a deal attention, focus, and fixation is? Whatever the gaze of our soul is locked onto, that actually is of supreme import and is premium and preeminent. For instance, if you look at quantum mechanics, like we know that subatomic particles change their behavior once they're observed. In fact, it could be that the universe could not exist unless there was some ever-present observer looking at these 150 plus subatomic quantum particles. Or if you look at religion, go to the Egyptian pantheon of divinities. If you look at Horus, he was the eye god, right? The eye of attention. Or if you go over to Jesus of Nazareth, what did he say? Make sure your eye is light, that your whole body may be light, but be careful that your eye's not dark, because oh, how great that darkness will be. Or American transcendentalism, when Ralph Waldo Emerson said, I am a transparent eyeball. What our eye, our focus, our attention is fixated upon is preeminent, important and premium, if you like the little P alliteration. But it's so huge what we're focusing on. And yet, we live in a generation that is so distracted. It's been said, if you're wondering why there's no more music as moving as Paca Bells, or minds as great as Lewis, or cathedrals as great as the Gothics, or stories as great as Tolkien's, it may be because the writers of these books, the architects of these buildings, the composers of these symphonies, and the authors of these tales are sitting on their couches watching television. I believe it was Don Miller. Actually, I know it was Don Miller who wrote that. And I would say Stephen King is also right when he said, sometimes it's not the great tragedies of life that make you want to kill yourself, it's just watching afternoon television that makes you want to commit suicide if you're watching one too many episodes of Judge Judy. And so if you're giving yourself over, if I'm giving myself over to the distractions of technology, it can cause our depression to be exacerbated. And that's what the data shows, that social media is a big reason why we're so depressed. But I don't want to get too much into that. I just want to say, whatever it is that is sapping you of your hope or zapping you of your emotional strength, do whatever you can to excise that more and more from your life, or even just to pare it back a little bit so that you can continue to focus on hope. Focus on hope. Focus on hope. Focus on hope. Because if your eye is light, your whole body will be light.